Osio, Johnny, Dawa, Do. And as you noticed, got not to be play here that I'm gonna watch, but I kinda like doing stat rundowns and how well I did and stuff. So my CS per minute 5.5, my KDA 4.3, my gold share 0.20, my death share 0.16, my kill participation 0.37, otherwise 37%, and then my total damage to champions that you can see, but my DPM for that part is 803.5625. But if we were to look at total damage dealt, the DPM would be 4678.375. Not bad. And then we move on to vision score. Why not? I'm actually surprised I. Okay, I'm not surprised I warded a lot, destroyed wards and stuff like that, because let's be real here, I was playing Pantheon. The enemy's not liking me, really. Here are the runes I used. I wanted to take cut down, but misclicked. It got coup de grace. Oops. Don't do that. But fortunately for me, that York didn't, as you can see, did not build any reason for me to take cut down. Anyway, that's enough rambling on. Let's just get to the replay. As soon as it will load. I honestly don't know why it does that. There we go. No, I didn't want to have to edit. But replay the word, but anyway, as you can tell, we have two tanks, an ADC, a seductress, and a bodybuilder. The enemy has lovebirds, person that plays too much Assassin's Creed, a doggy, and a guitar player. Kinda wish it didn't do that. Before you ask, yes, that is important to show. That our ADC actually took Relic Shield.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
Like, when did that actually catch on? Yes, that is probably one of the best starts for ADC. That also goes to show you that. Yeah, that also goes to show you that the person that starts Relic Shield or the team, they're always gonna win. Mostly since it provides a lot of beneficial factors for the bot lane. Like more gold income for the support. Instead of just relying off of the basic attacks he deals. Also, dueling shield, if you ask me, is not really a great start against Pantheon. Armor cloth is probably better. Though I can't wait till patch 8.2 to where Sightstone's gonna be gone and the quest line is replaced with the ability to place wards. That's actually, I actually got stuck there. Like, weird. Also, I don't blame this Yorick for playing very poorly at all, since he was only a Mastery 3. At the time of this game. And it's kind of preempted to destroy the wall for me. What's the key to show how much gold he has? Oh. Yet he didn't. Let's jump back. Back a bit more. All very interesting, but why did he not buy cloth armor? Like, I got more damage and a ruby crystal. I mainly got the ruby crystal because I was planning on building the black cleaver, as I thought the Yorick was gonna actually build armor and I wanted to shred it. I don't blame him for actually pinging me MIA since I went through the tri-bush and warded it. And I don't know how that did not hit me. And this Warwick, I know, is doing the smart thing, is farming up till he has his ult. Cause really, old Warwick is kind of like new Warwick. your shit if you gank before having ult. I kinda wish Ulex Vol gave you some CS. Not CS, some gold. Like at least one gold. Though what sucks is, upon the removal of Sightstone, champions that actually depend on it, like Nautilus, is losing something. He did not need to flash. Though granted, if he didn't flash, I would have flashed after him, but then he could have flashed, thus wasting my flash as well. And why opt to buy? Yeah, why ain't he buying? Was that X? Yes, it was. Why ain't he buying cloth armor, especially against the Pantheon? Like, I don't really blame him for not knowing the matchup much, but person that's doing a high amount of damage and has a reputation of known of being crap against tanks, you expect him to build some armor, go actual juggernaut pathing. But since he didn't, I decided, why not? I'll get another thing. Like, sure, later on he has innate tankiness a bit. That ult is kinda annoying with those things attached to it. But I didn't really care. As, whoops, he died. Like, he used his ult a bit too soon. And if you look, he's not maxing his W. Look, buddy, if you're actually watching this, W max first. And the combo is WE, and then you could Q or ult them. WE ult Q, maybe? I don't know. But yeah, I decided to grab some lethality since I figured he ain't building armor, so why not? Yet, he still has a lot of gold, and he really wants that Trinity Force. And yes, I did first pick Pantheon. But, I let my mid laner choose first. They chose Malphite. And then I picked Pantheon thinking, oh, that's good. Now we at least have two tanks. Because usually if our support's the only tank, I'll just pick a tank as of late. Because why not? We need one. Now I think about it, since most people taking 80 mids, a tank is generally good there. He waited too long for that. I flashed because I would have died though if I did not flash. And honestly, when you think about it, instead of going bot a lot, once that Warwick hit level 6, he should have tried to get the Pantheon. But then again, playing against people that Pantheon has a good time of punishing. As in people that makes mistakes. There's even a few times to where Yorick could have 1v1 me even though he ain't building so tanky. Yeah, he was just too scared to do it and I got stuck on the minions. How embarrassing. And here I just wait in the bush. Just to ambush the poor old little Yorick. It's like, boop. I don't know how my Q missed the target of Yorick and hit the minion. It's kind of why I keep telling people that Pantheon's... My Q even missed the maiden there. That Pantheon's Q is a skill shot if there is an enemy wave or a minion wave around the person or thing you're trying to kill. Because it can miss and happens quite a bit. But he still ain't building armor. And I got another control ward because why not? I was like, okay, I'm gonna get the phage because I want that black cleaver. Even if he ain't building armor, I at least like doing true damage. I don't know why he's just waiting there like that. Oh, I was tempted to get Sweeper Lens, but I knew if the Yorick was playing or performing this badly against a Pantheon, he's not going to be able to ward much. Also, it's not his fault. It's just, I'm a Mastery 7 Pantheon. And I know this matchup very well. Here's why, and thinking that he could counterpick like that, as usually Yorick should win. It's just, he doesn't really know his champion that well. Like the strengths, the weaknesses, or even the Pantheon matchup at all. which provided him the defeat at the end. Though he has Duskblade. Or a duck. It looked like he had... Was that a duck? No, that was Duskblade. Yeah, blackout. Causes a blackout for 8 seconds, revealing it. He should have just taken out the wood and gone out a bit, making me think that no one was there. But I'm actually paying attention a lot to my map. And right now I'm just having fun bullying people. When you get placed in low elo, it's fun. And then you start division skipping. Because you're playing so great. Also, that was a battle. Like, he should not have ulted. I don't know how that maiden got health back. I'm assuming it was from when it killed the actual target. And a lot of these people were unranked. Like the enemy Yorick. So I wouldn't know their rank from last season or if they had one. And Malphite came and he tower dived me, so I figured why not? I could get a 1-for-1 type of trade like that. Because of Malphite. That was some juiciness there. I don't know why he just dotted the blue buff when the Malphite was still following like that. And... Oh, he still don't get armor. Instead, he's getting the phage. Honestly, at this point, I am questioning on how well he actually knows the top lane matchup. But once I checked his, that only lasts for a few, but once I checked his profile, it said he was a Taric main. So I figured he's just main support. Yeah, that's strange since supports build armor. And by Taric main, I mean he really was a Mastery 7 Taric player. I honestly don't know why I E'd when I could just turn around and auto attack them all. I also found it a bit annoying that the ult kelp bringing York some ghouls. And yes, even though I was originally targeting his ult just for it being annoying, I had an extra reason to target it, because if I didn't kill it, it would have killed Eve. And I wouldn't want my Shadow Owl buddy to die. Though, speaking of Shadow Owl lore, it's kind of confusing when you think about some champions like Nocturne and Nautilus. Nocturne was literally found on the Twisted Tree Line from an abandoned Nexus. And Nautilus, he died defending Liegebard from the Shadow Owls. Yeah, there's no mention that he's a Shadow Owl champion or not. Which is very weird indeed. Also, I was gonna follow Nautilus there, I chose not to. Because there's no need. I had to run away from that or I would have died next tower shot. Though, I should have ran away from this too. As I forgot the range for that and how much damage it did. Oh, also, Yorki's building a Megaton cloak, yet still no armor. You'd expect by now that he'd build armor. And look, there's me with a black cleaver. Thinking, yep, it's time for me to kill stuff. Oh, damn it. I hate it when that happens. I also figured with top lane done like that, we actually taking his tower, time to roam. Then I figured, oh wait, York is still trying to take that tower top. Kind of pointless for him, but I should go help Nautilus. Nautilus looks on the minimap, sees me coming, and like, okay, why not? York wastes his flash when he could use it like about right now. Not exhaust, I take the last hit. Oh wow, Warwick is in the enemy jungle like that. It's kinda sad. And we see each other do like that. Here comes something fun. He's coming after me, I do that. It looked like he got stuck on a wall, but then realized that's not worth the risk of actually chasing me. But it also looked like that. He wondered, the fuck did I just do since I flashed through that wall to get away? Honestly, if I did not flash through the wall, I would have died. Oh, I also hate it when people actually try to play ranked when they have internet troubles. Yeah, it was a bad ult for me. So we lost the team fight. Last team fight and tower. Though, since they took the tower, if I was them, I would have rotated top and take that tower too. Since most of the manpower will be focused on this central area right here, defending that tower. I also figured, why not? Most of them are AA base, so I'm just gonna get Thornmail. I already got my two damage items. And does not much AP there. So Muck Threads, Thornmail, Rest. I was actually going to get a Omwrecker after Thornmail. Just because of why not? Also, York is finally getting some armor after this long into the game. Honestly, he should have got armor early on since it's a Pantheon matchup. I mean, come on. I kind of wanted to steal that kill with my ultimate, but eh. Either way, he got a flash from the Warwick. I was focusing the tower because I wanted to kill it before it killed one of them from the targeting thing. I was kind of hoping that would have been enough to kill Zaya. Yeah, I seen that control ward they placed, but I wasn't about to take the risk of destroying it yet. Whose ghost power was that? Usually I don't build boots on Pantheon because he has a good base move speed of 355. I also seen Yorick ulting up top, so I figured why not. I shall also ult up top. And yes, every time I killed him, I did flash my Mastery icon. I don't know why it's not showing though. Like honestly, I don't know why the mastery the icons are not showing. The emotes and stuff. Either way, I was just flashing my Impingu. If I really wanted to tilt them, I'd flash the Dab Pingu. Let it be known that most Pantheon mains always have an Impingu. Because it's one of the best emotes ever made. And if I didn't flash there, I would have taken another tower shot. I did not feel like it. Even if I would yaw moves out of there. Though, that Yorick should have built Thornmail or something similar early on. Either way, it's not too harsh on him. And I feel bad for them like that. Eh, it's like, meh. Actually, I don't feel bad for him at all, trying to counter pick my Pantheon. No, Sylvie. You try to counter pick my Pantheon, I'm gonna just beat you. Oh, hit. Anyway, until next time.